Next session, session four, was on advances in industrial waste and secondary reuse. And we have pleasure of having Dr. Kumar Panigrahi, the session chair. Dr. Panigrahi is a sustainability professional with over 22 years of experience in companies such as Perry Agro, which is part of the Bumagapa Group, Tata Refractories, and currently he's with the Mahindra Group, where he's the director of corporate sustainability, and in water security, waste, and circular economy. And in fact, he won an award, the Mahindra Innovation Award for Circular Economy Project. Please.
Welcome. Site chair, this is which is about advances in industrial waste recycling and reuse. And in this session we had Tejasri from Paris and Nirvan from RTA India. As you know, we discussed earlier also, Paris is one of the pioneers, and we have seen it. Cottage has started recently project called Kunha Project, where you know they have categories and they have documented 800 different types of waste, which is displayed. Is it there? It is displayed in one room. And they have a center where they do a lot of research on upcycling. And as shared by Tejasri, they are recycling almost 99% of the waste, which is very unique. Some of the best practices they have are like they're converting copper waste into chair, they're converting graphite dust into blocks, they're converting varnish waste, which is a category as hazardous waste in India. They are taking the varnish waste and they're applying tiles. The tile is reused by different companies. It's very unique. Look at the challenge you find here is hazardous waste, which is highly regulated, and there are a lot of things you need to do to really. One is to satisfy the regulatory bodies, and two is to really make sure that once upcycling of hazardous waste, it doesn't again go back to landfill. So there is the challenge huge. So there are a lot of good things in this aspect. One very interesting thing they have done is they have this hand gloves which is contaminated. So they have washed the hand gloves and they have converted the hand gloves into upcycled products. Like they have made a beautiful jacket. I'm not sure whether that is approved by the regulatory bodies, but if that is going to happen, then you have hundreds of thousands of tons of this cotton gloves all over India, which can be converted into this kind of product. Anirban from RTA India, actually it's a US company, and they are basically research and management company. He spoke about waste management technologies, and they are doing it Pune. And basically, they are training the applicants, and almost 2,500 applicants they are training, and they are making them a better person to better manage the waste materials, to better segregate the waste materials. He also talked about something called SWATS. And SWATS stands for Solid Waste Collection and Handling, which is very unique, which is also linked to Swachh Bharat Mission. So Nirvan and the company RTA can help other companies to make their roadmap on waste management, and they can also give research guidance on different types of waste. Finally, the company that I belong to, I am from Group Sustainability in Mahindra, and these roadmaps. We have already made plans for 20 locations, and every year we are going to convert some locations into zero waste facilities. Already, you know, for the first time in India, one of our locations, which is legal, it is a leading manufacturing unit of Mahindra division. It is certified as near zero waste landfill facility. First time in India. And India is certified by Interpol. And we are stuck in the last few percentage because of the hazardous waste. So possibly next couple of months we will get certified that as zero waste facility. Then we have developed a very innovative solution for farming waste, which is a big opportunity for us. There are more than 1 lakh tons of farming waste lying in Mumbai and Pune region. And so we developed a technology, we work with Mahindra Express, one of our company, and for a period of 6 months we did a lot of research. Although many people are working in farming waste, this is very unique. Because here we have a product which is technically, it is very good for use in the real estate sector, and we have internal market. So there is huge demand internally, and now the team is working on scaling up this project. So the concrete waste which is being generated by our auto division, everything will be utilized, and we have also got interest from other companies on this particular aspect. In certain other areas where we are working are like integrated waste management. For the first time in India, and I don't know about the world, but in India for the first time, we have developed a system where in a single container, shipping container, you can recycle all types of waste. And that is our trial phase now, and possibly within a month or so it will be operational. And if that happens, then you know you can set up those kind of units everywhere, or you can transport that recycling unit from one place to another. Then we have wooden waste. We convert the wood waste into benches and supply to schools. We convert the metallic products or metallic waste into different structures. So, and also, if you remember Mr. Ghosh was mentioning that in certain companies, some of the companies, we have converted waste and made separate business units. For example, this scrap, the art scrap company, now we are going to convert used cars into scraps, and we have developed a business model, and that is going to be operational in a couple of months. We have also conducted zero waste events in our couple of events that we conduct, like the last Mahindra cruise was a completely zero waste event. So these are some of the snapshots that we have. A lot of things will happen where. And we would like to collaborate with different companies across India, across the globe. We would like to collaborate with research companies as well as consultancies or NGOs on how to convert our waste into opportunities, how to use other waste in our market. And this is going to be a big thing in the future.